Hi, and welcome back to This Bytes For You. Today we're going to be doing an unboxing and an overview of the Arctic Freezer 2 420. This incredibly odd-shaped box holds a 420mm radiator. Again, the Arctic Freezer 2 420. This thing is tremendous. It's not sleight of hand or camera trick. It is huge, and the box is very awkward. But anyway, come over here real quick. I'll talk you through it as I'm doing the unboxing, and then coming up very soon, the Sinatra build will feature this very liquid cooling unit. So come over here real quick. Let's get started. All right, so here she is again, the Arctic Freezer 2 420. Again, a very oddly shaped box. You can see the massive radiator here, the fans and the pump. Doesn't do it justice just how big this is. Liquid Freezer 2 420 multi-compatible all-in-one CPU water cooler, including a little packet of MX4. Seriously, incredibly little. Now, it says a 2-year warranty, but I could have sworn it was a 6-year warranty. I'll go ahead and list it down below just to make sure. I don't want to misquote, but on the side over here, we go over in different languages the features and specs and everything, specifications here, fans, general, radiator, all that good stuff right there. Along the back, kind of some marketing of everything it does, the box contents, performance comparisons, all that good stuff here. And then on the ramp, just arctic.de, nothing much over here. So let's open it up real quick. Oh, okay, so it opens up like that. And I'm kind of afraid as to which way it's going to unfold. Okay, so it doesn't come out like, okay. So you gotta open it. I'm gonna twist it and pull it out like this, just so that you get a better idea. Okay, so comes out like this. Okay, nothing else in here, so I'm gonna put this big box down on the ground. Okay, incredibly odd, and I didn't think I'd need a knife, so I'm just gonna rip this tape off. So that you get a gauge on how huge this is. This is 18 inches long. That is tremendous. The tubes right over here, along with the pump, but I'm gonna skip that just for right now, just moving things out of the way. Let's see what comes in this oddly shaped accessories box. Like, you have to imagine, if it wasn't a triangle ramp thing, it'd be a tremendous box all on its own. So they made it smaller, but just awkward. So, Liquid Freezer 2 420, the QR code here. Okay, and then user manual, and then nothing along the back. I just adjusted the brightness. And then, thank you for choosing Arctic. Registration stuff here. Definitely register your products. And then over here we have, I'll go over this towards the end, but this is compatible with Intel sockets 1200, 115X, 2011-3, 2066, and a square ILM, and for AMD, socket AM4. All right, and again, I'm gonna save this one for last. I'll keep it in this weird box right over here. Hopefully it doesn't get in the way. And then we have, I'm going to put this on the ground. All right. So these tremendous fans, you can see right over here. And then the radiator, tremendous as well, with the Arctic right over here. Now, the radiator is 458mm by 138mm and 38mm in length and width and height, all that good stuff. the tubes coming down here to the pump is 455 millimeters. Okay, and then we can see down here the pump. Nothing's really changed, at least from looking at it, maybe a little tiny bit, between the 280 and the 360 I've reviewed previously. Still looks nice. Still, it is awkward looking, but it does look nice along the side. Arctic here. Then the VRM little fan right over here. The VRM fan is a 40 millimeter fan. Then over here, we can see the fins. So air coming in here, radiating out through here and the sides, trying to keep the VRMs and anything nearby nice and cool. Then along the bottom, we can see the cold plate. I'll keep this on there for now, but just remember during the installation, and you'll see me do it when you install, just remove that before you install it. Liquid freezer 2, 420, silk screened on there. DC 12 volt, 0.6 amps. And then we have the 4-pin fan header right here. Now, the pump will range anywhere from 800 to 2000 RPMs. It is PWM controlled, configured in your BIOS with this guy here. And the pump will consume between 5 watts and 7 watts, including the VRM fan. The cold plate is copper with microskeep fins. Now, the fan speeds on these guys ranges anywhere between 200 and 1700 RPMs. Again, all going through PWM since it is one single connection. All of these fans connect to each other. As you can see right here, they all connect to each other. So you don't need three or four separate fan headers. You don't need anything special. Everything is right here. So that's pretty awesome of Arctic to do that. Now, these are 140 millimeter fans, to be exact, the Arctic P14 PWM fans. Three of them, obviously, containing fluid dynamic bearings, as loud as up to 3 sohn, pretty impressive, and up to 72 CFM and 8 CFM for this guy down here, the VRM fan, and a static pressure of 4 millimeters H2O. Now, the entire package weighs 1,977 grams, so it's not incredibly heavy for what it is, and of course not incredibly light. Now, putting this aside, we'll go over everything in the packet here. All right. Ah, I see one thing I love already. Okay, so first off, wherever you're going to need to screw anything here or here into these little spacers or these risers or standoffs, I should say, you're going to want to put this in between that and the motherboard. That way, just in case you screw in too tight, you don't scratch anything, or when you go to remove it. Obviously, don't screw in too tight. You don't want to crack it, but this is just to protect it just in case. Okay, so starting off, these two right here that have this little standoff here, these are the AMD socket AM4 mounting clips. And these are the mounting clips for everything else. This is a backplate for the Intel socket 1200 and 115X, so everything 115. Now, this is the part that I said I loved already. They didn't include a little packet that you gotta, you know, push out. That's really annoying. They included a little tiny tube. Now, it may include the same amount as that little packet, but the fact that they have this that you can just, you know, pop on to put a little piece size right in the center of the CPU, I think this is awesome. Thank you, Arctic. Oddly enough, in the manual, they show the little packet instead of the little tube. So don't be surprised if you receive a packet. They might have run out of packets and included this instead. Now, coming over here, and I'm going to throw everything in here as we're doing this so we don't lose anything. Okay, so separating this out real quick. All right, so starting off, here they include 4 thumb nuts. And then right down here, they include 4 Intel socket 2066 and 2011 standoffs. Over here, we have 4 Intel socket 1200 and 115X standoffs. And then 12 screws right over here for the radiator. They might look a little bit smaller than they should be, but you can see that right over here. All right, and now opening up this packet. Okay, so then right over here, starting off, we have 4 AMD socket AM4 screws. And then 4 AMD socket AM4 spacers. Now, in this little packet, which thankfully is resealable. Let me sort this out real quick. Here we have 12 screws for the fans to connect to your case. 2 screws down here for the mounting clip. Then we have 12 flat washers right over here. Now, I don't particularly see in the manual what these are for, but that's okay. We'll go through the installation if we need it, as well as these 4 over here, these little teeny tiny screws. But if needed, we'll figure it out during the installation. So there are so many uses for the box alone. Arctic did an amazing job in the packaging, saving money, because if not, it would have been boop, big. So saving you money. Good stuff, Arctic. So they may have been the creators of the pyramids. If not, they could have been the creators of a ramp for Evel Knievel. Who knows? But anyway, Arctic so far looks like they did an amazing job with the 420. It is tremendous. It's nice looking. And if it's anything like the 280 or the 360, it's definitely going to be amazing. It's tremendous, so it's definitely going to be able to cool a ton. Mind you, you need to have a case that will fit it. If you saw the unboxing of the Corsair case I just did, that'll definitely take it. So stay tuned for the entire build coming up soon. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou out. See you guys.